Hi, my name is Sharonica, and you're watching Dante's Boxing Nation.
How did that one do?
That was very good. Do just maybe one or two more, okay? Dante's Boxing Nation, what's going on, guys? Be careful what you wish for. And I'm talking to old media when I say that. Devin Haney, he completely dominated the first fight with mainly his jab. And in the second fight, he flat out beats the shit out of George Kambosos, dominating him with the right hand, dominating him with lead hooks. Devin Haney was trying to knock out George Kambosos, and it was George Kambosos that was backing up. It was even George Kambosos that was initiating a lot of the clinches. I told you guys there's a very good chance that George Kambosos will either get hurt or knocked out if he fights a more aggressive fight. And in the first six rounds, George Kambosos was fighting a more aggressive fight and he was on his way out the door. George was on the verge of getting knocked out, and then that's when he decided to cruise. He took his foot off the gas because it got too hot in the kitchen. Then you had, I believe it was round 9 or 10, where Devin Haney came out in Mike Tyson mode. He went into that high guard and start backing up George Kambosos. George was very close to getting stopped in that round. If Devin would have just went to the body a little bit more, there's no way this fight would have went the distance. After that round, George Kambosos, he was in complete survival mode. He didn't even come close to really letting his hands go until it was the last round. And it was smart on George's part, because I think George remembered that Devin Haney took off the last round when they fought the first time. So it looked like George was planning on taking advantage of that in the rematch. He assumed that Devin would do the same thing, try to take off the last round, just cruise. And that's when George got aggressive and he made the round pretty close, but not close enough to win the round, because he lost that round as well. In fact, the scorecards were even more lopsided than they were the first fight. This was a great performance by Devin Haney. Even the boxing announcer said it was a war. We seen George Kambosos' face. He was in just a mask of blood everywhere, all over his face and the back of his head. Devin Haney had a pretty bad cut that was just pouring blood, and yet it was still Devin Haney that was pushing forward, forcing George Kambosos to back up or get on his toes and move. George Kambosos, he said he studied Duran and Chavez fights leading up to this fight, but actually came out trying to float like a butterfly and sting like a bee. You know, it's just amazing when you look at the dichotomy and you think about the fact that this is the same George Kambosos that beat Teofimo Lopez. But not only did George Kambosos beat Teofimo Lopez, he actually offered Lopez a rematch and Lopez turned down the rematch, which kills any excuse that Lopez tries to make for why he lost. Because there's no way you're going to turn down a rematch when you lose to someone if you feel that wasn't the best of you. You're going to avenge that loss. So my point is, just look at the difference of how George Kambosos looked when he was in a ring with Teofimo Lopez as opposed to how he looks when he's in there with Devin Haney. And this is the reason why George Kambosos, after the fight, did nothing but completely praise Devin Haney in his performance. I feel George Kambosos was actually hurting this fight bad. You know, he played it off a little bit, but you could kind of see he was hurt, especially when Devin Haney, when he went into Mike Tyson mode. And I think that's what made George Kambosos respect Devin Haney even more, when he seen how Devin Haney can just switch it up the way he did. So Devin Haney finally closes the chapter on Australia and George Kambosos. He most likely never has to go to Australia again for a fight. And it's on to the next. And on to the next for Devin Haney will most likely be Lomachenko, which will be a huge fight in the sport of boxing, because we all know that that's old media's number one guy right there. They've been using Lomachenko's name to discredit Devin Haney for years now. And I always tell you guys, unfortunately for old media, when they try to protect these fighters or put them on a pedestal, they actually put a curse on these fighters because they put a bigger target on their back. Usually, as soon as they start calling their favorite fighters pound for pound the best, how once again, they removed Devin from the pound for pound list and kept Loma on the list. when, of course, Devin is the undisputed champion and Loma has no belts at all. So doing things like that, what it does is it puts a bigger target on fighters like Lomachenko's back, which is the reason why Devin Haney is saying, I want Loma. I feel like that's the fight that I'm going to get the most credit for if I beat him, right? And if Devin Haney beats Lomachenko, that puts Devin Haney even higher on the pound-for-pound list because he's already pound-for-pound one of the best fighters in the world. But that just puts him higher on the list. So I look forward to seeing how Lomachenko looks against Jermaine Ortiz and the Devin Haney versus Lomachenko fight being announced. That's all I got for now, guys. I'm on to the next one. All
right, now check this out, guys. If you're looking to repair eczema scars, burns and bruises, dark spots and blemishes, the fever blisters, diabetic ulcers, this right here is the perfect product for you guys. It's called Elo De Key Face and Body Oil. Athletes and top-ranking boxers, they're also using it after training to reduce swelling and inflammation and to ease the pain. So get yours today. Go to elodekey.com.
Like them on Facebook and follow them on Instagram.